Good morning, dear students. Welcome in social science class. Dear students, we have completed our 14th chapter, that is your regional powers. And the next chapter is the Mughal Empire. Dear students, it's a very important chapter in Indian history. The Mughal Empires and how they came to India. The Mughals and the Mughal Empire is started after the end of Delhi Sultanate, where the last rulers were the Lodhis, which the Lodhi dynasty started by Behlol Lodhi, then after the Sikandar Lodhi, and then after Ibrahim Lodhi during 1517 up to 1526. But he was not that much capable ruler during that time and not able to carry Delhi Sultanate for a long period of time. And then after, the Babur came to India, attacked as well as fight with Ibrahim Lodhi and defeated also during the first battle of Panipat, as we have already discussed in previous topics. It took place in 1526 CE. So here we have the next chapter, the 15th chapter, the Mughal Empire. Babur attacked India in early 16th century when we have the 15 plus, then we, that's why it is called a 16th century. At that time, India was an easy prey for an invader, and it was divided into a number of small states, just like we have discussed in previous chapter, regional powers. Many small kingdoms rose just because of the incapability of the different rulers. These small kingdoms were incapable of standing up to any foreign aggression. Delhi had lost its glory under Ibrahim Lodhi. And Ibrahim Lodhi was not able to carry the whole empire for a long period of time. And his personal officials opposed him and invited Babur to invade India. The Ibrahim Lodhi's personal officials also not in favor of Ibrahim Lodhi. And what happened? They were just giving invitation to Babur so that you can attack over India and you can control over the huge empire. The situation in Punjab, this is your Punjab, here, Gujarat, here, Gujarat, then Bengal, here, Bengal, Malwa, here is your Malwa, look at it properly, and then Rajputana, here is Rajputana, Kashmir, these were the specific areas. These were totally controlled by the Babur during the initial stages, and their condition was quite bad, and there was widespread lawlessness and disorder just because of the weak incapability of the different officials. This is your map of the Mughals, how they came to India, and it is a time period of during 1605, the Mughal empires, this red shaded area, look at this. This was the empire of Mughals during the 1605 period. Next we have the local rulers were unpopular among the masses because they were not in favor of the different masses of the specific areas. At that time, Babur led the foundation of the Mughal Empire in India. He was getting all the advantages in the empire and the specific areas because the local people, they were not having the brotherhood among them, and that advantage was taken by the Babur and make his Mughal Empire in India. He was succeeded by his son Humayun, but it was Humayun's son Akbar the Great who proved to be the real glory of the Mughal Empire, and we can study about in detail in this chapter here. First Mughal emperors, we can say that they were main six Mughal rulers, although there were seven rulers, but the six main rulers we will discuss in this chapter. The first we have Babur. Babur's father's name was Umar Sheikh Mirza. Sometimes it is very important for the GK point of view. You can write Babur, his time period was 1526 to 1530. He fought first battle of Panipat with Ibrahim Lodhi and defeated also. He won and Ibrahim Lodhi defeated. Zahiruddin Muhammad, commonly known as Babur, that is Tiger, was the great grandson of Timur and a descendant of Turkish ruler Genghis Khan. We have already discussed these topics during the chapter, the Turkish invasion in India, the Turks as well as the Genghis Khan, the Caliphs also, who had invaded India several times. Babur was a brave soldier, an experienced general, a skilled horse rider, a sure shooter, and a skilled swordsman. Many qualities he was in taking himself. After becoming the ruler of Kabul, he conquered Ghazni. He came from Kabul. He conquered Ghazni and Samarkand areas also in Afghanistan and Pakistan area. But his failure to bring Samarkand permanently under his control made him give up his ambition of expanding his empire in Central Asia. He exactly wanted to control over these areas, but due to many issues, he was not able to conquer these areas. He had to head towards India. Babur was also attracted by the fabulous wealth of India. That time, India was known as the Golden Sparrow, but everybody was attracted for the wealth of India. That's why many rulers came from different countries and attacked or invaded India for their wealth. Just like we have discussed about the Mahmud Ghazni also, the Somnath Temple during 1025 CE. Babur became the ruler of Hindustan by defeating the army of Ibrahim Lodi in the First Battle of Panipat in 1526 CE. Babur's victory ended the power of the Afghans and boosted his economic security and influence. He distributed his wealth generously to buy the confidence of the public and Afghan chiefs who had opposed him. In order to have complete control over North India, he also wanted to control over the whole North India to increase his power or his empire. Babur had to defeat Rajputs as well. Just like in previous chapter, we have discussed about the Mewar and the Malwa as in Marwar, the Rana Sanga and the Battle of Khanwa, where the two sides met, a fierce Battle of Khanwa. It was took place on 18th June 1527, where Rana Sanga was defeated by Babur. And later on, further also, many battles were there, like Haldi Ghati battle was also there with Akbar. That time also, they were defeated by Akbar, and Akbar was expanding his power slowly and gradually throughout the India. This defeat ended the power of great warriors, the Rajputs, because in Rajasthan area, the Malwa, Mewar, these areas, Rajputs warriors were there and their rule was there. Babur was not only a great military commander, but also a learned scholar as well. He wrote Babur Nama, very important question, sometimes asked in exams, in MCQ, Babur Nama or Tuzuke Babri. He wrote Babur Nama or Tuzuke Babri in Turkish language. It is an autobiography of Babur. It includes important events related to the Babur's life. He wrote the book about his life, which is known as Babur Nama and Tuzuke Babri. So this was all about today's topic, the introduction part of the Mughal empires, as well as the first ruler Babur. You read up to this and I'll ask any question from any students. So this much all about. Thank you.